let you know how, Toto. Toto! There you go. Did she hurt you? She tried to, didn't she? Oh, Toto. She must be the meanest old woman that ever was. Let's go tell Uncle Henry and Auntie Em. They'll take care of her. Come on, Toto. Just listen to what Miss Gulch did to Toto. She...
Dorothy, please, we're trying to count.
Oh, but Annie M, she hit him.
Not now, honey. We're busy. Look, the old incubator's broken. We're likely to lose a lot of our chicks.
Oh, poor little things. Oh, but Annie M, Miss Gulch hit Toto right over the back with a rake just because she says he gets in the garden and teases her nasty old cat every day.
Dorothy, please.
But he doesn't do it every day. Just once or twice a week. And he can't catch that old cat anyway. And now she says she's gonna get...
Dorothy, we're busy.
Oh, Uncle Henry, can't you do something?
Honey, we're busy. Please, just stay out of our hair.
Oh, all right.
Who is the genius who suggested we move the wagon before putting the wheel on?
Well, it ain't so heavy with one less. That makes sense, don't it?
Sense or no sense, when I lift up the axle, you two shove her on.
Zeke, Hickory, you know Miss Gulch did to Toto?
I swear, they made this new wheel smaller than the other one.
She tried to kill him!
Bigger or smaller, get it on here for my arms pulled clean out of its socket. I ain't a statue, you know. I ain't made of iron.
Okay, okay.
Why won't anyone listen? Don't you care about Toto?
Ow! Oh, you got my finger!
Oh, what am I gonna do about Miss Gulch, huh? Just because Toto chases her old cat.
Now look it, Dorothy, you ain't using your head about Miss Gulch. Ain't you got no brains?
Sure I have brains.
Well, then how come you don't use them? Now look, when you come home from school, don't go by Miss Gulch's place. Then Toto won't get in her garden, and you won't get in no trouble, you see?
What are you just standing around for? You get that wagon cleared out. We have a parcel of lumber to get to town before the weather turns.
Will do, Mr. Gale.
Oh, Zeke, what am I gonna do?
Well, for a start, kid, don't let that old Gulch heifer try and buffalo you. She ain't nothing to be scared of. You gotta stand up to her, that's all. With a little courage, a little grit.
I'm not afraid of her.
Now that's what I wanted to hear. Walk with your head up, your chest out, and the next time she squawks, you stroll right up to her and you spit in her eye. That's what I'd do.
Would you really?
Sure I would. Through this life, you gotta walk tall, shoot straight, and then you got no reason to be scared of nothing and nobody.
Oh, Zeke, are you all right?
What are you trying to do, kill a guy?
Oh, how can you be so cruel?
It's just a rib, Dorothy.
Oh, can't you see how white he is? You really scared him.
Who was scared?
You were scared. If you was a jackrabbit, you'd be in the next county by now.
Here, here. What's all this jabberwapping when there's work to be done? I know three shiftless farmhands that'll be out of a job before they know it. Well, we was just having a little fun, Mrs. Gale.
A farm is no place for fun. If you want fun, go join a circus.
Might just do that. Be a strong man. See the world.
Well, don't start posing for it now. Here, can't work on an empty stomach. Have some cookies.
Oh, gee, Mrs. Gale.
Just baked.
Thanks.
Well.
You don't have to sit down to eat them. Get the wagon hitched up. And Zeke, you feed those hogs before they worry themselves into anemia.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, Annie M, really? You know what Miss Gulch said she's gonna do to Toto? She said she was gonna get...
Dear, you always get yourself into such a fret over nothing.
Well,
just help us out today and then find yourself a place where you won't get into any trouble.
Place where there isn't any trouble. Suppose there is a place, Toto. There must be. It's not a place you can get to by boat or train. It's far, far away. Behind the moon, beyond the rain. When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found, leading from your window pane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh, why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh,
by the barn?
I never skulked a day in my life, Miss Gulch, and I ain't about to start now.
I want to see you and your wife right away about Dorothy.
Dorothy? Now, what has Dorothy done?
What's she done? I'm all but lame from the bite on my leg.
You mean she bit you?
No, her dog.
So she bit her dog, eh?
Afternoon, Miss Gulch. I've just baked a fresh batch of cookies, if you'd mind to sit a while.
I'm afraid I have no appetite, Mrs. Gale. Indeed, I am so shaken by the ferocious attack of your niece's vicious dog, I may never eat again.
But if you don't eat, you'll waste away, and oh, I'd hate to see you dwindle.
Dorothy, could you bring Toto out here a minute? I'm sure if Dorothy's done anything to upset you, she'd be only too glad to apologize as best that she can.
It's gone beyond apologies, Mrs. Gale. I have laid an official complaint with the county sheriff.
Was he sober?
Dorothy, Miss Gulch here seems very upset.
That dog's a menace to the community.
Well, that's not true.
As an act of public service, young woman, I am taking that dog to the sheriff and making sure it is destroyed.
Destroyed? Oh, Toto? Oh, you can't, you mustn't. Oh, Uncle Henry, Annie M., you won't let her, will you?
Of course we won't, will we, Em?
Oh, please, Annie M., Toto didn't mean to. He didn't know he's doing anything wrong. I'm the one that ought to be punished. You can send me to bed without supper.
You hear how sorry the child is? Surely if she promises to give your place a wide berth.
If you don't hand the dog over now, I will bring a damage suit that will take your whole barn. There's a law protecting folks against dogs that bite.
Well, how would it be if she kept him tied up? He's really gentle. With gentle folk, that is.
Well, that is for the sheriff to decide. Here's his order allowing me to take the dog. Unless you want to go against the law.
Yeah.
What's it say, Henry?
Well, it's just as she says. I'm sorry, hon, but you're gonna have to hand over Toto.
No, I won't let you take him!
We can't go against the law, Dorothy. I'm afraid poor Toto will have to go.
Now you're seeing reason.
No!
This is what I'm taking the dog in, so it can't attack me again.
No, no, I won't let you take him! You go away, or I'll bite you myself!
Dorothy!
Oh, you wicked old witch! Uncle Henry, Annie M, don't let her take Toto! Don't let her take him!
Stop her!
Oh,
it's no use running, Dorothy.
Hickory, I thought you were my friend.
Oh, he is your friend. We all are. You can't fight the law, honey. Some things are bigger than all of us.
Hand her over.
Oh, please, please.
Hand her.
Put her in the basket, Henry.
That's more like it.
Don't, Uncle Henry.
That's more like it.
Oh, Toto.
Almira Gulch, just because you own half the county doesn't mean you get the power to run the rest of us. For 23 years, I've been dying to tell you what I thought of you. And now, being a Christian woman, I can't say it.
Well, I can, and if you don't want to hear it, you best peddle your carcass off of my land.
I don't take kindly to that kind of talk, Henry Gale. Just remember, I have friends in high places.
Well, then why don't you just climb on your broomstick and go visit them? You got that wagon hitched up yet?
Nearly done, Mr. Gale.
Well, nearly ain't good enough. You get it done right now. Sky's getting dark every minute, damn it.
Yes, sir.
Come inside, honey.
I'm not going anywhere with you. If you really loved me, you wouldn't let Toto go.
She had an order from the sheriff, Dorothy. What did you expect me to do? Wave a wand and make it disappear?
You still could have tried, at least. And you stood there like you were stuffed or something.
I just couldn't think of anything. I'm sorry.
One mean old woman, you were scared of her?
It weren't my place to interfere.
And you're worst of all. You stopped Toto from getting away. I hate you.
Oh, don't say that, Dorothy. You make me feel terrible inside. Like my heart was all torn out.
I don't care. I never want to see any of you again. Ever, ever, ever. Toto was the only friend I had in the world. Now I got no one to talk to. No one to play with. And I'll never see him again as long as I live. Toto? Toto? Oh! You came back! Oh, you got away from that horrible woman! Oh, you wonderful dog! Oh, but she'll be coming back for you any minute. We've got to get away. We've got to run away. Oh, we'll need food for me and a bone for you, and then we've got to get far, far away from here. And we're never, ever coming back.
Here, doggy, doggy. Here, doggy, doggy. Where is that dreaded animal? Here, doggy, doggy, you mangy mutt.
I thought I told you to get off of my land.
I did, but the dog got away.
Well, I can't have enjoyed your company much.
Where the girl is, that is where I'll find the dog. Kindly bring her out here.
You never give up, do you? Dorothy! Dorothy!
She ain't in the house, Henry. And that fresh batch of cookies I made is gone. And my picture from the mantel, it's gone too.
Sounds like you've got a runaway on your hands. Don't worry. If she's on the road, I'll find her. And then I'll take that dog back. For good.
If you care about her so much, you should have taken better care of her.
Don't blame me. The catch in the basket is faulty. That is the last time I buy anything from a charity bazaar.
It were done, it were best to be done evenly on both sides. Oh, what's this? A house guest, eh? Oh, now let me guess. You're Going on a visit. Oh, no, that's not it. You're traveling in disguise. Oh, no, 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 I'm wrong. You're running away from home.
How did you guess?
Professor Marvel never guesses. He knows. Now tell me, why are you running away?
Well...
Oh, no, let me guess. They don't appreciate you at home. They don't understand you. You want to see big mountains, big oceans, big cities.
Why, it's just like you can read what's inside of me.
It's my trade, my calling. See what it says on the side of my conveyance.
Oh, please, Professor, why can't we go with you and see all the crown heads of Europe?
Do you know any? Oh, you mean the thing. Yes, well, I never make any decisions without consulting my crystal first. Here, have a seat, right here, yes. Yes, that's it. I don't talk. Now just make yourself comfortable while I conjure out of the air, out of thin air, this very genuine, a magic, authentic crystal used in the days of the pharaohs of Egypt by the priests of the Isis and Osiris, in which Cleopatra first saw the approach of Julius Caesar and Mark Antony and so on. You'd better extend your hands, my child, so I may better read into it, yes. Now, you'd better close your eyes to be better in tune with the infinite. Yes, to do these things, one must reach out into the infinite. That'll do. You may open them. And now let's gaze into the crystal and see what appears. I see a house with a white picket fence.
Well, that's our farm.
There's a woman. Her face is careworn.
Well, that's Aunt Em.
Her name is Emily.
That's right. Well, what's she doing?
Oh, well, it's hard to see her. Oh, I'd say so. It looks like she's crying.
Oh.
Someone has hurt her very much. Someone has just about broken her heart.
Well, why would anyone do that?
Well, I don't know, but it's someone she loves very much. It's someone she's taken care of in sickness.
Well, I had the measles once, and she stayed right by me every minute.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, but that was when I was very young. She doesn't care about me at all now, and I don't care about her.
Well, that's not what the crystal says.
Oh, they were going to kill Toto, and she did nothing to stop them.
I don't see any of that in the crystal. All I see is a woman who does her very best and misses you something fierce.
Well, what's she doing now?
Oh, well, what's this? She's falling down onto the bed. She's placing a hand over her heart.
Oh, well, you don't suppose she really could be sick, do you? I've got to get home right away.
Oh, what's this? I thought you were coming with me.
Oh, no, I've got to get to her right away. Come on, Toto. Oh, goodbye, Professor Marvel, and thanks a lot.
Goodbye. A safe journey. Whew. I better get the horse under cover. Storm's blowing in a whopper. Oh, poor little kid. I hope she gets home all right.
It's a twister! The RC blows!
And it's headed straight for us.
Last time one of them struck, it tore the big barn clean out of the ground and left a cow on one of the telegraph poles.
I cut through the horses!
Good man.
Dorothy!
You ain't found her then?
She must be somewhere out in the storm. Dorothy!
It's getting awful close, Mr. Gale. Everyone to the storm cellar.
We can't leave her out here, Henry.
Oh, there's nothing else we can do, Em, except pray for all of us.
Annie! Uncle Henry! Toto. I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. We must be over the rainbow. I know we're not in Kansas.
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Who, me? Well, I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
Oh, well, is that the witch?
Toto? Oh, Toto's my dog.
Oh, well, I'm a little muddled. You see, the Munchkins called me because a new witch has just dropped her house on the Wicked Witch of the East. And here's the house. And there you are. And those legs are all that's left of the Wicked Witch of the East. And so, what the Munchkins want to know is, are you a good witch or a bad witch?
But I already told you, I'm not a witch at all. Witches are old and ugly. What was that?
The Munchkins. They're laughing because I'm a witch. I'm Glinda, the Witch of the North.
You are? Oh, I beg your pardon. But I've never heard of a beautiful witch before.
Only bad witches are ugly. The Munchkins are happy because you have freed them from the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh, but if you please, what are Munchkins?
The little people who live in this land. And blue is their favorite color. This is Munchkin Land, and you are their national heroine, my dear. It's all right. You may all come out and thank her. Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She brings you good news, well, haven't you heard? When she fell out of Kansas, a miracle occurred.
It really was no miracle. What happened was just this. The wind began to switch, the house to pitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then, a witch, to satisfy an itch, went flying on her broomstick, thumbing for a hitch.
And oh, what happened then was great.
The house began to pitch, the kitchen took a switch, it landed on the Wicked Witch.
And sing and ring the bells out, ding.
Munchkin City, in the county of the Land of Oz, I welcome you most regally.
But we've got to verify it.
Legally.
To see.
If she.
Is morally, ethically.
Spiritually, physically. Positively, absolutely, undeniably, and reliably dead.
As coroner, I must aver, I thoroughly examined her, and she's not only merely dead, she's really most sincerely dead.
Friend, this is a day of independence for all the Munchkins and their descendants.
If any.
Yes, let the joyous news be spread. The wicked old witch at last is dead.
Her then?
Well, of course I recognized her. Who else would wear ruby slippers with those socks? The ruby slippers. Little girl, you have done me a great service. I shall don the ruby slippers, which will make my powers greater than ever. slippers! They're gone! The ruby slippers! What have you done with them?
See for yourself. Step forward, Dorothy.
Give those slippers back to me, or
else it's too late. There they are, and there they'll stay.
Give those back to me. They're of no use to you. I'm the only one that knows how to use them. Give them back to me. I said give them back!
Keep tight inside of them. Their magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
You stay out of this, Glinda, or I'll fix you as well.
Oh, fiddle-faddle. You have no power while I'm here. Be gone, before someone drops a house on you too.
Very well. I'll bide my time. And as for you, my fine lady, it's true I can't attend to you here and now, as I'd like. But after a suitable period of mourning, I will have those slippers. And my revenge, too. So best try to stay out of my way. Just try. I'll get you, my pretty. And your little dog, too.
It's all right. You can get up. She's gone. It's all right. You can get up. Ugh, what a smell of sulfur. I'm afraid that you've made a rather bad enemy of the Wicked Witch of the East. The sooner you get out of Oz altogether, the safer you'll sleep, my dear.
Oh, I'd do anything to get out of Oz altogether. My Annie M is missing me. She may be ill, but which is the way back to Kansas? I can't go the way I came.
No, that is true. The only person who might know would be the great and wonderful Wizard of Oz himself.
The Wizard of Oz? Oh, is he good or is he wicked?
Oh, very good. But very mysterious. He lives in the Emerald City. And that's a long journey from here. Did you bring your broomstick with you?
No, I'm afraid I didn't.
Oh, then you'll have to walk. The Munchkins will see you safely to the border of Munchkinland. And remember, don't let those ruby slippers off of your feet for a moment, or you will be at the mercy of the Wicked Witch of the West.
Well, how do I start for the Emerald City?
Well, it's always best to start at the beginning. And all you have to do is follow the yellow brick road.
But what happens if I...
Just follow the yellow brick road.
My, people come and go so quickly here. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick road. Follow the yellow brick, follow the yellow brick, follow the yellow brick road.
Which way do we go?
Excuse me, but that way's very nice.
Who said that? Oh, don't be silly, Toto. Scarecrows don't talk.
Of course, it's pleasant down that way, too.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Then again, people do go both ways.
Why, you did say something, didn't you? Are you doing that on purpose, or can't you make up your mind?
Oh, well, I haven't got a brain. Only straw. So I ain't got a mind to make up.
Well, how can you talk if you haven't got a brain?
Well, I don't know, but a lot of people without brains do an awful lot of talking, don't they?
Yes, I guess you're right. Can't you get down?
Oh, down? Oh, no. You see, I have a pole up my back.
Oh, well, is there any way I can help you?
Well, of course, I'm not too bright about doing things, but maybe if you bend the nail in the back, I'll slip off.
Oh, I'll certainly try. Oh, it's an awful stiff nail.
Oh! Oh! Oh, there goes some of me again.
Well, Does it hurt you?
Oh, no, I just keep picking it up and putting it back in again.
Well, let me help you.
Well, thank you. My, it's good to be free!
Oh!
Did I scare you?
Oh, no, I just thought you hurt yourself.
But I didn't scare you?
No, of course not.
Well, I thought not. You see, I can't even scare a crow. They come from miles around just to eat in my field and laugh in my face. You see?
Said a scarecrow swinging on a pole to a blackbird sitting on a fence. Oh, the Lord gave me a soul, but forgot to give me common sense.
Said the blackbird, well, 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 what in thunder would you do with common sense?
Said the scarecrow, 'twould be pleasing just to reason out the reason of the witchness and the whiness and the whence. If I had an ounce of common sense,
why, yes,
I could while away the hours conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head I'd be scratching while my thoughts were busy hatching. If I only had a brain, I'd unravel any riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain.
With the thoughts you'd be thinking, you could be another Lincoln.
If I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore.
You could think of things you never thought before.
And then I'd sit and think some more. I would not be just a nothing, my head all full of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a ding-a-dairy if I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thunk before.
And then he'd sit and think some more.
Gosh, it would be awful pleasing to reason out the reason for things I can't explain. Then perhaps I deserve ya and be even worthier of ya if I only had a brain. If I only had a brain.
Why, if our scarecrow back in Kansas could do that, the crows would be scared to pieces.
Oh, they would?
Mm-hmm.
Where's Kansas?
Oh, well, that's where I live. And I want to get back there so badly, I'm going all the way to the Emerald City to get the Wizard of Oz to help me.
You're going to see the Wizard?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that if I came with you, the Wizard could give me a brain?
I couldn't say. But even if he didn't, you'd be no worse off than you are now.
Yeah, that's true.
But maybe you better not. I've got a witch mad at me, and you might get into trouble.
A witch? I ain't afraid of no witch. I'm not afraid of anything. Except for a lighted match.
Oh, I don't blame you for that.
Oh, but I'd face a whole box full of them for the chance of getting a brain. Now look, I won't try to manage things because I can't think. And I won't be any trouble because I don't eat. Oh, please, won't you take me with you?
Oh, well, of course I will.
Oh, boy, I'm gonna get a brain!
Oh! Well, you're not starting off very well.
Oh, I'll try. Really, I will.
To Oz?
To Oz!
We're off to see the Wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Here he is, a whiz of a whiz, if ever a whiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a whiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the Wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
You're hungry? But I thought only crows got hungry.
Well, all living things need to eat.
I don't need to eat. Oh, does that mean I'm not alive?
Oh, no, Scarecrow. Why, you're the liveliest friend I've ever had.
Oh, thank you. And just for that, you can eat as much of my hay as you like. And then you won't be hungry anymore.
Oh, no, Scarecrow, I couldn't do that.
Oh, really, you don't have to worry about me. You see, as long as I keep my legs well stuffed, it doesn't matter what shape I'm in up top.
Oh, it's a very kind offer, but I don't eat hay.
Oh. Well, I suppose it's just as well. You see, there's a little mother dormouse in here, and she wouldn't like to be disturbed.
Oh, look, Scarecrow, apples!
Apples? What's apples?
In the trees!
Oh! Oh, you mean the little red birds who hang upside down by 1 foot?
They're not birds. They're something you eat, and they're delicious. Ouch!
What do you think you're doing?
Well, we were walking a long ways, and I got hungry. Did you say something?
Ha! She was hungry!
She was hungry!
How would you like it? Have someone come along and pick something off of you.
I'm sorry. Oh, I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
Well, come along, Dorothy. You don't want any of those apples. Ugh.
Are you hinting our apples aren't what they ought to be?
Oh, no. It's just, she doesn't like little green worms.
Worms? Did he say we have worms? That's what it sounded like to me.
I'll show you how to get apples. I'm sure you got worms. You got worms, caterpillars, and probably a whole bunch of woodlice, too.
How dare you? Let's give it to him, girl.
Look out, Dorothy.
Take that.
Oh.
And that. Hey, slanderer.
I like them apples.
Well, we like them just fine.
Oh, no. I'm suddenly swayed. So am I. They think I'm all of them.
I think it's time to bow down.
Why? It's a man. A man made out of tin.
A what?
Yes. Look. Did you say something?
Oil can.
He said oil can.
Oil can what?
Oil can? Oh, here it is. Where do you want to be oiled first?
He said his mouth.
Oh.
On the other side.
There. My goodness. I can talk again. Oh, oil my arms, please. Oil my elbows. Oh. Oh. Oh, did that hurt?
No, it feels wonderful. I've held that axe up for ages.
Oh, goodness. Well, how did you ever get like this?
Well, when I was flesh and blood like you, I fell in love with a munchkin maiden whose mother hated me. So, to stop me from marrying her daughter, she hired the Wicked Witch of the West to put an evil spell on my axe. When I went to chop down a tree, I chopped off my leg instead.
It chopped your leg off?
Well, that's terrible.
But by good fortune, I knew of a wonderful tinsmith who gave me a new leg just as good as the old one. So back I went to work. And you know what happened?
Oh, something terrible, I bet.
I swung my axe, and dang me if it didn't take off the other leg.
Well, you should have gotten a new axe.
I guess you're right. But I got a new leg instead, and back I went to work.
Well, you sure were persistent.
This time, I chopped off both my arms.
Oh, my.
Now, I can see how you could have chopped off one arm, But how did you chop off the other one?
I told you, the axe was enchanted.
Well, of course. You see, Dorothy, if I had a brain, I could have figured that out for myself.
Sometimes I wish I hadn't gotten a new pair of arms from the tinsmith. Because the last time I swung my axe was the worst time of all.
Oh, I don't want to hear this.
What happened?
I split myself right down the middle.
Oh, you poor thing.
So, the tinsmith gave me a new head and body, but on my way home, I got caught in a terrible rainstorm and rusted solid.
Well, it just wasn't your day, was it?
Been here ever since.
Oh, well, you're perfect now. My neck.
Perfect? Just bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead. Bang on it.
Beautiful! Oh, what an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart.
Oh.
All hollow. And as long as I have no heart, I can never love my munchkin maiden.
Oh, don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rust again.
I used to carve her name on every tree.
You can say that again.
Yet.
Oh, well, perhaps you can visit the tinsmith again and ask him to give him a new heart.
Oh, he went out of business a long time ago.
Ran out of tin.
Well, then, why don't you come with us to the Emerald City and ask the Wizard of Oz for a heart?
Suppose he wouldn't give me one when we got there.
Oh, but he will. He must. Oh, we've come such a long way already.
You're the one that put the spell on my axe.
Yes, and it certainly chopped you down to size, didn't it? And now, you're helping the little lady along, are you, my fine gentleman?
Well, stay away from her, or I'll stuff a mattress with you, Scarecrow. And you, Tin Man, I'll use you for a beehive.
Well, I'm not afraid of you.
Well, that just proved that you don't have any brains. Allow me to educate you. Here, Scarecrow.
Wanna play ball?
Help! 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 I'm on fire! Help! Help! Help!
Just remember, Scarecrow, helping that girl reach the Emerald City could be your last burning ambition.
Well, I'm still not afraid of her. Stuff a mattress with me. I'll make sure you get to the Emerald City now, whether I get a brain or not.
I'll see you reach the wizard, whether I get a heart or not. Beehive, bah. Let her try and make a beehive out of me.
Oh, you're the best friends anybody's ever had. And it's funny, but I feel as if I had known you all the time. But I couldn't have, could I?
Well, I don't see how. You weren't there when I was stuffed and sewn together, were you?
And I was standing there resting for the longest time.
Still, I wish I could remember. But it really doesn't matter. We know each other now, don't we?
That's right.
We do.
To Oz?
To Oz.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Here he is, a wizard of a wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever, oh, ever a wiz there was, the Wizard of Oz is one. Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Dead in that wild forest.
If I were there, I'd be petrified.
I don't like this forest. It's dark and creepy.
Of course, I'm not too bright, but I think it's gonna get darker before it gets lighter.
You suppose there'll be any wild animals?
There might.
Animals that eat straw?
Some, but mostly lions and tigers and bears.
Oh, lions!
And tigers?
And bears.
Oh, lions and tigers and bears! Oh, my!
Lions and tigers and bears!
Oh, my!
Lions and tigers and bears!
Oh, my!
Lions and tigers and bears!
Oh, my!
Lions and tigers and bears!
Oh, my!
Lions and tigers and bears!
Oh, my!
Put 'em up, put 'em up! All right, which one of you is first? I'll fight you both together if you want. I'll fight you with one paw tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot. I'll even fight you with my eyes closed. Oh, pulling an axe on me, yay. Sneaking up on me, yay. Why?
Here, here. Go away and let us alone.
Scared, huh? Afraid, huh? How long can you stay fresh in that can? Come on, get him and fight, you shivering junkyard. Put your hands up, you lopsided bag of hay.
Well, now that's getting personal, lion.
Yes. Get up and teach him a lesson.
Well, what's wrong with you teaching him?
Well, I hardly know him.
Oh, I'll get you in the way, Pee-wee.
Oh. Shame on you.
What'd you do that for? I didn't bite her.
No, but you tried to. Oh, it's bad enough picking on a straw man when you go around picking on poor little dogs.
Well, you didn't have to go and hit me now, did you? Is my nose bleeding?
Well, of course not. My goodness, what a fuss you're making. Well, naturally, when you go around picking on things weaker than you are. Why, you're nothing but a great big coward.
Oh, you're right, I am a coward. I haven't any courage at all. I even scare myself. Look at the circles under my eyes. I haven't slept in weeks.
Why don't you try counting sheep?
That doesn't do any good. I'm afraid of them.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Why don't you come with us to the Emerald City? We're going to ask for a heart for him.
And him a brain.
Oh, I'm sure he could give you some courage.
Well, wouldn't you feel degraded to be in the company of a cowardly lion? Oh, I would.
Oh, no, of course not.
Well, gee, that's awfully nice of you. My life has been simply unbearable. Even my family's disowned me. Why, when I was just a cub, my father took me to the top of a high mountain, waved his paw out and said, "One day, son, all this will be yours." Oh, I was terrified.
Why is that?
I'm scared of heights.
Well, it's all right now. The wizard will fix everything.
Well, at least you'll be safe if I come with you.
How's that?
No self-respecting wild animal will come anywhere near me. Said a lion. Poor, neurotic lion. To a miss who would listen to him rave. Oh, the Lord made me a lion, but the Lord forgot to make me brave. Then his tail began to curl and to wave. Life is sad, believe me, missy, when you're born to be a sissy without the feminine verve. But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the nerve. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. But I could show my prowess, be a lion, not a mouse, if I only had the nerve.
Oh, you'd be in your stride, a king down to the core.
You could roar the way you never roared before.
And then I'd roar and roar some more. I would show the dinosaurs who's king around the forest, a king they better serve. Why, with my regal beezer, I could be another Caesar if I only had the nerve. I'd be brave as a blizzard.
I'd be gentle as a lizard.
I'd be clever as a gizzard.
If the wizard is a wizard who will serve.
Then I'm sure to get a brain.
A heart.
A home.
The nerve.
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. We hear he is a wizard of a wizard, if ever a wizard there was. If ever, oh, ever a wizard there was, the Wizard of Oz. Why? Because of the wonderful things he does. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz.
Now, shall I squash them out like the interfering little bugs they are? Or shall I be witty and creative? The bug alternative is attractive but messy. So, witty and creative wins the day. Aha! Something with poison in it, I think. Yes, with poison in it, but attractive to the eye. And soothing to the smell. Poppies. 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 This lethal lullaby will put them to sleep forever. And then the ruby slippers will be mine.
Yellow Brick Road seems to go on forever.
Well, if you're tired, Dorothy, we can take a shortcut.
The road curves around this poppy field. We can cut through and pick up on the other side.
Well, come on, let's go.
Oh. Oh, I've never seen such beautiful poppies.
I think poppies are my favorite flower.
Oh, the smell is so wonderful. Oh. Oh. What's happening? What is it? I can't run anymore. I'm so sleepy.
Well, here, give us your hands and we'll pull you along.
Oh, no, no, I have to rest just for a minute. Toto, oh, you lay there, Toto. We can have a little sleep together.
No, you can't sleep now. We have to go on.
Oh, come to think of it, Footy Winks wouldn't be such a bad idea.
Oh, no, don't you start too.
It's the poppies. That's what's doing it.
Oh, don't cry now. You'll rust again. Oh, this is a spell, this is!
It's the Wicked Witch! What do we do? Help! Help!
Well, it's no use crying for help. No one can hear you. Help! Help! Help!
We hear you, Scarecrow. And knowing you can undo the magic of the Wicked Witch, perhaps a little magic of my own will save the day.
Snowing.
Unusual weather we're having, ain't it?
Oh no, he rusted again. Quick, someone give me the oil can.
Oh, I don't have the oil can.
I just realized something.
What?
I'm sitting on it. Wow, those poppies are powerful stuff. I didn't feel a thing.
Dorothy, you're awake.
My white magic has done its work. Journey's End is now in sight.
Oh, the Emerald City! Oh, we're almost there! At last, at last!
You're out of the woods, you're out of the dark, you're out of the night. Step into the sun, step into the light. Keep straight ahead for the most glorious place on the face of the earth or the sky. Hold on to your breath, hold on to your heart, hold on to your hope. You're out of the woods, you're out of the dark, you're out of the night. Step into the sun, step into the light.
Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it? Just like I knew it would be. Oh, he really must be a wonderful wizard to live in a city like that.
Well, come on, let's go.
What are we waiting for?
On to Oz!
To Oz!
We're off to see
the wizard. We're off to see the wizard.
We're off to see the wizard.
The wonderful wizard of Oz.
Okay.
Who rang that
doorbell? Oh, don't do that.
We did.
Can't you read?
Read what?
The notice.
What notice?
The notice. Why, it's as clear as the nose on my face. Yes! Oh. 1 minute, please.
Bell out of order. Please knock.
That's more like it. Now state your business.
We want to see the wizard.
The wizard? Why, nobody sees the wizard. Nobody's ever seen him. I've never seen him.
Well, then... how do you know there is one?
Because. If there weren't a wizard, why would you be here?
Oh, please, please, sir. I've got to see the wizard. The good witch of the north sent me.
Ha! Prove it!
She's wearing the ruby slippers she gave her.
Well... so she is. Well, bust my buttons, that is a horse of a different color. Hang on a minute.
Who's he calling a horse? Why, if he wasn't on the other side,
he's coming out.
Oh, he'd be on this side.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to the Emerald City.
Oh, thank you.
Have you come far?
Oh, just the longest of ways.
Well, every step was worth it. Oh, have you any idea just how beautiful this place really is?
Well, I've been trying to imagine it, but I haven't got a brain.
They said I'd fall in love with it, if I had a heart.
It's the one place I don't need courage, because there's nothing to scare me. Is there?
There's a garden spot, I'm told, where it's never too hot and it's never too cold.
Where you're never too young and you're never too old.
Where you're never too thin or tall.
And you're never, never, never too anything at all.
At all, it's true! Oh, we're not too mad and we're not too sane, and we don't compare and we don't complain. All we do is just sit tight, 'cause it's all so downright right! Hurry, hurry, hurry!
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old lands of Oz. Buzz, 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 chirp, 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 and a couple of la-dee-da's. That's how the crickets crick all day in the merry old lands of Oz. We get up at 12 and start to work at 1. Take an hour for lunch, and then at 2 we're done.
Jolly good fun!
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away in the merry old lands of Oz.
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, and a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we melt the day away with a ho ho ho, ho ho ho, in the merry old land of Oz.
Oh, it's everything you said it was, and more.
When do we get to see the wizard?
Will you take us to him?
Is he scary?
The wizard, the wizard, of course. But first I'll take you to a place to tidy up in. Follow me.
Oh, thank you.
Jolly good fun!
Ha ha ha, ho ho ho, a couple of tra-la-las. That's how we laugh the day away from the merry old land of Oz.
Oh, it's the witch! She's followed us here!
What's she doing with all that smoke?
She's writing with it.
Oh, what's it say? What's it say?
Surrender, Dorothy.
Oh. Dorothy? Who's Dorothy? The wizard will explain it.
To the wizard!
To the wizard!
To the wizard!
All right, you can stop that. Now stop that. It's all right. The wizard has got everything under control.
I hope.
So you can all just go home. Go home.
Go home.
Well, didn't you hear me? I said go home.
Well, that's what I'm trying to do, sir. That's why I've got to see the wizard right away. All five of us.
Sorry. Orders are nobody sees the wizard. Not nobody, not no how.
Oh, but please, please.
You said you'd take us to see him.
I got a permit just for the occasion.
Not nobody, not no how.
Oh, you just gotta make him see, Dorothy.
Dorothy? Dorothy, like the witch's Dorothy.
In person.
Well, that does change things. You stay here. I'll announce you at once.
Did you hear that? He'll announce us at once. Oh, I've good as got my brain.
I can fairly hear my heart beating. I'll be home in time for supper.
In another hour, I'll be king of the forest. Long live the king!
If I were king of the forest,
not queen,
not duke, not prince, my regal robes of the forest
would be satin,
not cotton, not chintz. I'd command each thing, be it fish or fowl, with a ruff and a ruff and a royal growl. As I'd click my heel, all the trees would kneel, and the mountains bow, and the bulls kowtow, and the sparrows would take wing. Fie, were king. Each rabbit would show respect to me, the chipmunk's genuflect to me. Though my tail would lash, I would show compassion for every underling. If I were king, just a king. Oh, shucks. Of all I survey.
Your Majesty, if you were king, you wouldn't be afraid of anything?
Not nobody, not no how.
Not even a rhinoceros?
Imposterous.
How about a hippopotamus?
Why, I'd thrash him from top to bottom.
Supposing you met an elephant?
Why, I'd wrap him up in cellophane.
What if you met a brontosaurus?
I'd show him who was king of the forest.
How?
How? Courage. What makes a king out of a slave? Courage. What makes the flag on the mast wave? Courage. What makes the elephant charge his tusk in the misty mist or the dusky dusk? What makes the muskrat guard his musk? Courage. What makes the Sphinx the seventh wonder? Courage. What makes the dawn come up like thunder? Courage. What makes the Hottentot so hot? What puts the ape in apricot? What do they got that I ain't got?
courage.
You could say that again.
For courage is the thing of things.
With courage I'd be king of kings.
And the whole year round I'd be hailed and crowned by every living thing.
I were king.
Go away.
The wizard says go away.
Go away?
Oh, but surely.
Ah! He is deaf to all appeals. The wizard has spoken.
Oh. Well, it looks like we came all this way for nothing.
Oh, and I was so happy. I thought I was on my way home.
Don't cry, Dorothy. We'll see you reach the wizard.
Oh, we certainly will.
Annie, Emma was so good to me, and I never appreciated her. Running away and hurting her feelings. Professor Marvel said she was sick. She may be dying, and it's all my fault. I'll never forgive myself. Never, never, never.
All right. Look, I'll take you to see the wizard to stop crying.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, it's nothing. I had an Annie M myself once. Follow me.
Wait a minute, fellas. I was just thinking. I really don't want to see the wizard miss much. You should go on without me. I'll wait out here.
What's the matter? The wizard's gonna give you some courage.
Oh, I'd be too scared to ask for it.
Oh, come on, Lion. We'll be scared together.
Oh, okay.
Oh! What happened?
Somebody pulled my tail.
You pulled it yourself.
Oh. Oh, I'm such a butterpaws.
This way!
Look, boss awaits.
Tell me when it's over. I want to go home.
I am Oz, the great and powerful. Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you?
If you please, sir, I'm Dorothy, the small and meek. We've come to...
Silence!
Oh, Jiminy Crickets!
The great Oz knows why you have come. Step forward, Tin Man.
Oh.
Dare you come to ask me for a heart, you clinking, clanking, clattering collection of collagenous junk?
Oh, yes. Yes, sir. Yes, Your Honor. You see, a while back we were walking down the Yellow Brick Road and...
What? Oh. And you, Scarecrow. Have you the effrontery to ask me for a brain, you billowing bale of bovine fodder?
Yes, Your Honor. I mean, Your Excellency. Or, I mean, Your Wizardry, you see. I always wanted
to... Enough! And you, Lion.
Oh, no, no. Hi.
Whoa!
You ought to be ashamed of yourself, frightening him like that when he came to you for help.
Silence! The beneficent Oz has every intention of granting your requests.
What's that? What did he say?
Are you all right?
Just a little deaf. What did he say?
He's going to help us after all.
He is?
But first, you must perform for me one small task.
One small task? Oh, is that all?
You name it and it's half done.
Bring me the broomstick of the Wicked Witch of the West.
But if we do that, we'll have to kill her to get it.
Bring me her broomstick, and I will grant your requests. Now go.
But what if she kills us first?
I said go!
Pretty gone!
Oh, I wish you'd just given up on this crazy quest. I should have never taken you to see the wizard.
Oh, but I'm glad you did. Well, how else can I get back to Kansas?
You don't have to worry about us.
We're not going to the witch empty-handed.
Let's say that again. Now, which way to her castle?
Well, no one knows for sure.
You mean no one's ever gone there?
Oh, plenty of people have gone there, just no one's ever come back.
Boy.
Oh, there's no yellow brick road to follow now.
Oh, there's no road at all to the land of the Winkies.
Winkies? What are Winkies?
Ah, Winkies were people, just like you or me. Except the witch captured them and made them her slaves. Oh, I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you.
Oh, so do I.
Well, just keep going west where the sun sets.
Is that the best way to find the Wicked Witch?
Oh, don't worry. Once the witch knows you're in the land of the Winkies, you won't have to find her.
She'll find you.
Good luck!
Sometimes it's good not to have a brain, because I haven't got the wit to be scared.
And I haven't the heart to fail.
And I haven't said goodbye to the wizard. Oh.
How can you desert Dorothy now?
Well, I could stay here. That's one way of doing it.
Well, shame on you. You're an even bigger coward than I thought.
Well, it's easy for you to say. You're made out of straw, and you're made out of tin. But I am only weak, weak flesh.
Very weak.
Verging on flabby.
It's all right, Lion. You can stay here if you'd like.
Oh, I'd like, oh, how I'd like. But if you really need me to come, I guess I'll tag along.
Now that's the spirit.
Stout fellow.
Ready to go, Dorothy.
Best foot forward.
Oh, decisions, decisions.
Come on, Lion.
Oh, I'm coming, I'm coming. Scarecrow's not the only one who needs a new brain. Oh.
All right, all right. I'll conjure up a spell that'll take the bite out of her. Now, which one of my creepy, crawly creations shall I send to plague her? The Liberty Gibbet? No, no. Oh, the Fly by Night? No, no, no. Uh-huh. I have it! The Jitterbug! Well, may you gibber. There is no more infectious bug in my book of spells. Once infected, they can never stop dancing and dancing until they drop. And when they do, you will be there to scoop up the little brat and the little brute and bring them both to me. Now go, do my bidding. Fly, fly! Fly soon, those darling ruby slippers will grace my dainty feet.
Does anyone know where any of us are?
Well, we passed a notice a while back.
Oh, you mean the one that said, welcome to the haunted forest?
No. The one that said, if you made it this far, you're lost.
Here's another notice.
I hope it says something a little more reassuring.
I'd turn back if I were you.
Okay.
Oh, I believe there's spooks around here.
That's ridiculous. Spooks? That's silly.
But don't you believe in spooks?
No, my only fools.
Oh, I do believe in spooks. I do believe in spooks. I do.
So do I. Did you just hear what I just heard?
That noise don't come from an ordinary bird.
It may be just a cricket or a critter in the trees.
It's giving me the jitters and the joints around the knees.
I think I see a shadow and it's fuzzy and it's furry.
I haven't got a brain, but I think I ought to worry.
I haven't got a heart, but I feel a palpitation.
As Monarch of the Forest, I don't like the situation.
Are you gonna stand around that fills full of horror?
I'd like to roar him down.
But I think I lost my roar.
It's a who's this?
It's a who's this?
It's a what's this?
It's a what's this?
Who's that?
Who's there?
Who's where?
Beware!
That hiding in the treetop. It's that rascal, the jitterbug. Should you catch him buzzing around you, keep away from the jitterbug. Oh, the bees and the breeze and the bats in the trees have a terrible, horrible buzz. But the bees and the breeze and the bats in the trees couldn't do what the jitterbug. So just be careful of that rascal. Keep away from the jitterbug.
The jitterbug. Oh, the bees and the breeze and the bats in the trees have a terrible, horrible buzz. But the bees and the breeze and the bats in the trees couldn't do what the jitterbug does. So just be careful of that rascal. Keep away from the jitterbug. The jitterbug. The jitterbug. The jitterbug.
Thank you.
The treetop tips that rascal to the pub. Should you catch him, but him, out him. Keep away from to the pub. For the beast breeze, that's trees. Had the terrible, horrible buzz. But the beast breeze, that's trees. Couldn't do what the chicken bug does. Do what the chicken bug does. So be careful of that rascal. Keep away from chicken bug. Chicken bug. Chicken bug. Chicken bug. Chitterbug. Look out for that bomb. Oh no! Not again!
I'm suffering from metal fatigue!
I'm gonna sit this one out!
Please leave
me alone! Who?
Oh, what's happening?
Oh, look at the size of these birds.
They're not birds. They're monkeys.
Flying monkeys!
We're getting away with Dorothy. Get away from me, you pesky apes.
Fine job we did protecting Dorothy.
Help! Help!
What happened to you?
They tore my legs off and threw them over there. And they tore off one of my arms and threw it over there.
Why, that's you all over.
It's time you pulled yourself together. Well, I would, but I can't reach my legs. Oh, I'll get them.
And then we'll go find Dark.
That's right. And the lion will lead us.
Yeah. Me?
Yes, you.
I'm gonna lead us against the forces of evil.
That's right.
Okay, I'll do it. I'll do it for Dorothy. Wicked witch or no wicked witch? Guards or no guards, I'll tear them apart. They may not come out alive, but at least I'll go down fighting. There's just one thing I want you fellas to do for me.
What's that?
Oh, talk me out of it.
This way, my dear. I trust you had a pleasant flight. It's so kind of you to visit me in my loneliness. Give me the dog.
Oh, where are you taking Toto?
Tonight we feast on Devil Dog.
No!
It's all right, my dear. Just a little joke. She'd look even more revolting with an apple in her mouth.
Oh, where are you taking her? Why can't she stay with me?
Oh, because the raging, roaring river is some ways off. Is she a water breed?
I don't think so.
Well, she soon will be, because that is where we're going to drop her. If you don't, hand over the ruby slippers.
But the good witch of the north told me not to.
Very well. Drop that dog into the deepest point of the river and drown her.
Oh, no, no, please! You can have the slippers yourself. I don't want them. Just give me back Toto.
That's a good little girl. I knew you'd see reason.
Run, Toto, run! As far as you can!
Catch her, you fool!
Run, Toto! Oh, you got away. You got away from her.
Which is more than you'll ever do.
Fool that I am,
I should have remembered. Those slippers will never come off. As long as you're alive. You see this? That's how much longer you've got to be alive. And it isn't long, my pretty, not long at all. Just long enough for me to devise an unpleasant but wildly entertaining death for you. Of course, there is one route of escape. It's a long way down and the rocks are sharp. So, if you do decide to go this way, be a darling, leave the ruby slippers on the windowsill. It'll save me the trouble. I'm having to take them off of your corpse.
How can anyone be so nasty, mean, and cruel?
Lots and lots of practice.
me, it's Annie M. We're trying to find you. Dorothy!
I'm here in Oz, Annie M. I'm locked up in the witch's castle, and I'm trying to get home to you, Annie M.
Dorothy!
Oh, Annie M., don't go away! I'm frightened! Come back, Annie M.
Come back, Annie M. I'll give you Auntie M. my pretty.
What's that?
That's the castle of the Wicked Witch of the West.
Dorothy's in that awful place.
Oh, I hate to think of her in there. We've got to get her out somehow.
Oh, don't cry now. We don't have the oil can, and you're squeaking enough as it is.
But they say it's got 1,000 rooms. How are we ever going to figure out which one Dorothy's in?
Hey, it's Toto.
Here, Toto.
She'll lead us to Dorothy.
But we still got to get into the castle.
Do you think I'll be polite, like dropping in like this?
Look out!
Who's that?
I think I've got a plan on how to get us in there.
He's got a plan.
It might not work.
It might not work.
But it's got a chance.
It's got a chance.
The only thing is, it's very, very dangerous. What do you say?
I say, anybody else got a plan?
Let's hear Scarecrow's.
First, we're gonna need to find 4 Winky uniforms.
Where are we going to find 4 Winky uniforms?
I don't know, but the whole plan depends on it.
Fellas.
4 Winky uniforms.
Oh, I don't think we have to look very far.
How come?
They're right behind us!
We've got no time to lose.
We can't take her out the way we came.
What about the window?
Oh, the cliff is sheer.
Oh, don't worry. You hang on to my tail, and I'll hang on with my claws.
Oh, you're wonderful, all of you.
Oh, I just hope my courage holds out.
We hope your tail holds out.
To the window.
To the wall.
Oh, will we, Winky?
I think we've outstayed our welcome.
The sands of time have run out for all of you. The last to go will see the first 3 before her. And you're mean, you little mutt, too. Now, meeny, meeny, miny, mo. Who will be the first to go? Lion? No. Girl? Tin Man? No. My broom has chosen Scarecrow.
No! No! Help! Help!
What's the matter, Scarecrow? Don't you
Dad! Look what you've done! Oh, I'm melting! I'm melting! Ah! Who would have thought a good little girl like you could destroy my beautiful wickedness? Oh, what a world! What a world! I'm melting!
Can I believe my eyes? Why have you come back?
We did as you told us, sir. We brought you back the broomstick of the Wicked Witch of the West. We melted her.
Oh, you liquidated her, eh? Very resourceful.
Yes, sir. So, we'd like you to keep your promises to us, if you please, sir.
Not so fast! Not so fast! I'll have to give the matter a little thought. Go away and come back tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Oh, but I want to go home now.
You've had plenty of time already.
Yeah!
Do not arouse the wrath of the Great Oz. I said come back tomorrow.
If you were really great and powerful, you'd keep your promises.
Dare you presume to criticize the great and powerful Oz? You ungrateful creatures! Consider yourselves lucky that I'm giving you an audience tomorrow instead of 20 years from now!
Toto!
The Great Oz has spoken! Now go!
Toto, come out of
there! I said go! Oh! Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain, the great and powerful Oz has a... spoken.
Who are you?
Well, I am the great and powerful Wizard of Oz.
You are? I don't believe you.
No, I'm afraid it's true. There's only me.
You humbug!
Yeah! Yes, that's right. I'm a humbug.
You're a very bad man.
Oh, no, my dear. I'm a very good man. I'm just a very bad wizard.
Well, what about the heart you promised Tin Man?
And Scarecrow's brain.
A brain is a very mediocre commodity. See, back where I come from, we have what's called a university, where men go to become great thinkers, and they come out thinking great thoughts, and with no more brains than you. But they have one thing you don't. A diploma!
Go, go, go. What a diploma is.
Therefore, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the Universitatis Comitiatum e Pluribus Unum, I present to you the honorary degree of Ph.D.
Ph.D.?
Yeah, that's a doctor of thinkology.
The sum of the square roots of any two sides of an isosceles triangle will be equal to the square root of the remaining side. Oh, joy! Rapture! I've got a brain! Oh, how can I ever thank you enough?
Well, you can't.
Oh.
As for you, my fine friend, You are under the unfortunate delusion that simply because you run away from battles means you have no courage. You are confusing courage with wisdom. You see, back where I come from, we have men who are called heroes. Once a year, they take their fortitude out of the mothballs and parade it down the main street of the city. And, with no more courage than you have. But they have one thing you don't. A medal! Therefore, for extraordinary valor, meritorious conduct, conspicuous bravery against wicked witches, I present to you the Triple Cross. You are now a member of the Legion of Courage.
Oh, shucks, folks. I'm speechless.
And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. You don't know how lucky you are not to have one. A heart is a very mediocre. It'll never be practical until it can be made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Back where I come from, we have men who do nothing all day but good deeds. They are called good deed doers. And their hearts are no bigger than yours. But they have one thing that you don't. A testimonial! Therefore, in recognition of your kindness, I take great pleasure at this time with presenting you with a small token of our esteem and affection. And remember, my sentimental friend, that a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are loved by others.
Oh, it ticks. Listen, it ticks.
Read what my medal says.
Awarded for courage.
Ain't it the truth? Ain't it the truth?
Oh, they're all so wonderful.
But what about Dorothy?
Yes, what about Dorothy?
Yeah, Dorothy next.
Yes, Dorothy.
Oh, I don't think there's anything in there for me.
Well, you forced me into a cataclysmic decision. The only way to get Dorothy back to Kansas would be to take her myself.
Oh, will you? Could you? Oh, but are you a clever enough wizard to manage it?
Oh, child, you cut me to the quick. I'm an old Kansas man myself, a balloonist par excellence to the Miracle Wonderland Carnival Company. Until one day, when performing feats of the stratospheric skill, the balloon failed to return to the circus.
It did?
Spooked, were you?
Spooked! You are talking to a man who has laughed at death, sneered at doom, chuckled at catastrophe. I was petrified. Then suddenly, the winds changed. And the balloon came down in the heart of this fair city where I was instantly acclaimed Oz, the first wizard, Deluxe.
Ooh. Deluxe is from the French, pertaining to luxury.
Well, there were a few luxuries in way with the job, but I took it anyway, retaining the balloon against the advent of a quick getaway. The balloon is ready for the flight, and in that convenience, my dear Dorothy, you and I will return to the land of the E, Pluribus Unum. Right this way! Citizens of Oz, I, your wizard per Ardua Ad Alta, am about to embark upon a hazardous and technically inexplicable journey into the outer stratospheres. To confer, converse, and otherwise hobnob with my fellow wizards. And until that time, if any that I may return, I leave the Scarecrow, by virtue of its highly superior intelligence, to rule in my stead, assisted by the Tin Man, by virtue of his kindness, and the Lion, by virtue of his courage. Obey them as you would me. Thank you, my friends. Oh, I believe it's time to cast off. Climb aboard, Dorothy, climb aboard.
Climb aboard, Dorothy, while the wind's in your favor.
Where's Toto? Oh, I can't leave without Toto. Toto!
Oh, don't worry, I'll get her for you.
Oh, don't let go of the rope!
What?
This is absolutely unprecedented!
Oh, don't go, Professor!
Help! It's too late, my dear.
Oh, you can't go without me!
Help! I can't come back! I don't know how it works!
Goodbye,
my friends! Oh, bye. That idiot guard just ruined my exit!
Now I'll never get home.
Then stay with us, Dorothy.
We don't want you to go.
I have to get back to Kansas.
But don't you love us, Dorothy?
Oh, you know I do. But there's a place and people I love more. And now it's further away than the furthest dream. Oh, Scarecrow, I'll never see Kansas again as long as I live. Never, never, never.
Never is a very, very long time, Dorothy.
Oh, please, will you help me? Can you help me?
You don't need to be helped any longer. You've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
I have?
Well, then why didn't you tell her sooner?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn it for herself.
What have you learned, Dorothy?
Well, I think that it isn't enough just to want to see Uncle Henry and Annie M. And that if I ever go looking for my heart's desire again, I won't go any further than my own backyard. Because if it isn't there, then I never really lost it to begin with. Is that right?
That's all it is.
Oh, but that's so easy. I should have thought of it for you.
I should have felt it in my heart.
Me too, if I had the courage of my convictions.
No, she had to learn it for herself. Now, those magic slippers will take you home in 2 seconds.
Toto too?
Toto too.
Oh, but it's going to be so hard to say goodbye. I love you all so much. Goodbye, Tin Man. Oh, don't cry. You rust so dreadfully. Here's your oil can. Goodbye. Now I know I've got a heart, because it's breaking. Goodbye, Lion. I'm going to miss the way you used to holler for help before you found your courage.
When you go, I think I'm going to do a little more hollering.
Dear Scarecrow, you are my first friend here. I think I'll miss you most of all.
Well, having a brain don't make parting any easier.
Goodbye, Dorothy. I'll think about you always.
Are you ready now?
Oh, yes, please. Before I change my mind and stay here forever.
Then close your eyes and tap your heels together 3 times and think to yourself over and over, there's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home.
1.
There's no place like home.
2.
There's no place like home.
Goodbye, Dorothy.
Oh, I'd hate to think of that child out on night in the storm.
Well, I best we go to town and notify the sheriff.
Wait!
Dorothy!
Oh, there she is!
Oh, Dorothy! Oh! Zeke! Hunk! Hickory! I found her! Tell Aunt Em and bid her bring a blanket.
Oh, she's got a lump on her head the size of an ostrich egg, but the skin ain't broken.
Hello, Oz!
Oz? My first name is Chester, but you can call me whatever you like.
Uncle Henry! Oh, you were the guard.
Oh, I'm guarding you now, honey, and I'll make sure no more harm come to you.
Is she okay?
She's fine. There's a minute there, though, I thought she'd left us.
Oh, but I did leave you, Uncle Henry. That's just the trouble. And I tried to get back for days and days.
Oh, sounds like a bad dream.
Oh, it wasn't a dream.
Sure it wasn't. You remember me, your old pal Zeke?
Lion!
No, I ain't. And this here's Hickory.
Couldn't forget my face, could you?
Oh, of course not. But where's Scarecrow?
Scarecrow?
Who the heck's Scarecrow?
Here's the blanket you wanted. Oh, is she all right?
She's fine.
What happened to all your stuffing?
Stuffing?
What'll happen to the field mouse you had in your stomach?
Oh, I had more than a field mouse. You gave me a whole sack of kittens in here.
Dorothy!
Annie M!
Dorothy, you're safe and well.
Oh, thanks to you, Annie M. You showed me how to use the slippers.
Oh, I won't use the slipper on you, honey. You haven't done anything wrong.
No, no. You don't understand. This was a real, truly live place. And I remember some of it wasn't very nice. Oh, but most of it was beautiful. And you were all there. You kept rusting up. And you kept pulling your tail and...
were a humbug.
Well, now, let's not get personal.
Doesn't anybody believe me?
Of course they believe you, Dorothy. But now we've got to get you into bed.
Has the house come back? It fell on the witch, you know.
Well, the storm passed right by it.
And it wasn't a house that fell on Miss Gulch.
It was a telegraph pole.
Oh, we won't be hearing from that old biddy till she gets her leg out of the plaster.
Then Toto's safe. You hear that, Toto? We're safe. And we're on our way home. Home. And you're all here. And I'm never gonna leave here ever, ever again. Because I love you all. And oh, Annie M, there's no place like home.
We'll be right back.